Hi, this is Gary with MACMOST.com. Today, let's look at using overlays in iMovie for the iPhone and iPad. MACMOST is brought to you thanks to a great group of more than 700 supporters. Go to MACMOST.com/Patreon. There you can read more about the Patreon campaign, join us, and get exclusive content and course discounts. So many times in the past, I've showed you how to use Keynote on a Mac to create overlays that you can then use in iMovie. Things like text or symbols or graphics, anything you want to put up over your video and have it be semi-transparent. Now you could do the same thing using only your iPhone. You're using the same two apps there, iMovie to do your video editing and Keynote to create the overlay. So let's start off here in iMovie. Let's create a new project. I'm going to make it a movie project. And we'll go to my photo library and ask me to select a photo or video to start with. Actually, I can select multiple ones. But let's just select one here and I'll hit the checkbox there. Let's just create a simple movie here that just has this one clip in it. Now you can see here the timeline at the bottom and the preview there at the top. Now the idea is we want to add an overlay that goes on top of this video. So let's switch to Keynote and create a new Keynote presentation that we're going to use as an overlay. I'll choose the basic black layout there. So first let's get rid of the boxes that are there. So we start off with a blank slide. Now let's create a new text box. I'll hit the plus button at the top. I'll make sure I select at the top the text and shapes and then go to basic and text is the first one there. So I'll put some text there in the middle. Let's zoom in by pinching with two fingers outward there. So now I can see this text. Tap it twice. Now I can enter in some text. We'll just do my overlay and then I'll tap off of it. Now let me tap it again to select. I'll hit the paintbrush there at the top so I can then set text properties. Let's make it something a little more interesting. I'll set the font here to something else and let's make it bold and let's make it much larger and anything else you want. Then I'll hit the X button there. Let me shrink down the slide so I can see the entire slide again. Let me position this in the middle. It will lock to these little guides here. Now I may not want to place this text in the exact middle of the video frame, but that's okay. We'll have a chance to move it. For now, let's go and export this out. So I'm going to hit the paintbrush tool at the top without the text selected. And I'm going to go to appearance. And this will allow me to change things about the slide. It's important you don't have anything selected when you do this. Otherwise, it's going to give you properties of the element you have selected. With nothing selected, it'll give you the slide itself. So here under background, I can select background and I can choose no fill. That's very important. This won't work without that. Now we want to go and export this. So I'm going to tap on the button at the top right and I'm going to select export. I'm going to select images. And now I get to select several things, slide range, the type of file. I want to make sure I've chosen PNG as the file type. I also want to make very sure at the bottom I have transparent backgrounds turned on. Without setting the background to no fill and setting this transparent background switch to on, we won't get a transparent overlay. So it's very important you do both of those. Now let's export. Now you're going to get a lot of options here for exporting. The one we want to use is save to files. This will save it as a file. Now you could save this anywhere you want in your iCloud drive. I'm going to save it into the iMovie folder. But you can create a folder in your documents folder called overlays anywhere you want. Just remember where you save it. It's just like saving it on the computer. You need to remember where the file is saved so you can access it later. And at the top you can see the name there. I'm going to select that so I can set the name to something else. So I'll call it My Overlay. And I'll hit Done. And now Save. Now let's go back to iMovie. Switch to that. And let's add this overlay. I'm going to hit the plus button. And I'm going to select Files at the bottom. Now I need to go to the same place where I saved that file. So in this case it's in the iMovie folder and there is my overlay. I'm going to tap that to select it. Now it's going to say add to movie or more. I want to tap more because I'm going to add it in a special way. I don't want to just add this as a regular photo or video to my iMovie project. I want to add it as picture in picture. This is the only option that will give you a semi-transparent overlay. So I'll add that and now you can see it adds it to the top there. You can see it. I can select it there. It's over the regular video. Make it larger or smaller. I can drag it left or right. Notice you could see it there in the video. Now with it selected, you can see I have three options. A little magnifying glass a cross with four directions and a box. I want to use the middle one, the cross there with four directions. This allows me to position and resize the overlay. Notice while I'm working with it, it's opaque. It's not transparent anymore, but that's okay. I can move it around and put it where I want. I can also use two fingers to shrink or grow it. So I can make it nice and big and maybe put it here in the upper left hand corner instead of in the center. Then I just tap that same button again and now it sits there. I could do that as much as I want to actually move it around to get it in the exact spot. Now we can make all sorts of overlays like this. So if I go back to Keynote here, I can actually edit this slide, or maybe let's just add a new blank slide. Maybe use this Keynote presentation as kind of my scrapbook for overlays. So I'm going to add here something like, let's say, a shape. I can go and do a symbol like this, put a trophy there. I can then go in, zoom in here. I can select the trophy. I can make it larger. Might as well make it as large as possible since I can resize this very easily. Let me get it in the center of the slide here. I can change properties of it. So let me hit the paintbrush. Let's go and change the style, change the fill to maybe something like a gradient fill like that. And the idea is the rest of the slide is going to be transparent. To confirm that by hitting the paintbrush with nothing selected, go to Appearance and check the background. Set that to no fill. And you can see that's on a slide by slide basis. So by creating a new slide that had a black background, I had to change it to no fill. Let's go and export this second slide. I'll tap the three dots there. Export images. Instead of all images, I'll just select slide 2 from 2 to 2 there. Then I will make sure it's PNG, make sure transparent backgrounds is checked. I can export, select save to files. Give this a name. Hit done. Save. Now I can switch to iMovie. And let's add this in as an overlay. I'll hit the plus button there. Files. There's the trophy that I created. Let's hit more. Picture in picture. And now it's sitting right there as an overlay. You can see that's an overlay there. I can reposition this where I want it to be like that. And if you want to have more than one overlay happening at the same time, it's simple. You just add both of those overlays to the same slide in Keynote. So I might have a trophy or a thumbs up and some text in the same slide. And then export that as a special overlay to be used at that portion of the video, and have that as the single picture-in-picture on top of my existing video. So I have tons of other overlay ideas and videos I've done in the past for the Mac. You can create little pop-ups, little thumbs-ups, little emojis that appear in different parts of your video, text that you have appear in a way that you can't do with titles in iMovie. And you don't have to use Keynote if you don't want to. Any graphics app that will create a semi-transparent image will work. For instance, I tested out the Pixelmator app and was able to export a transparent image from there, use that as an overlay in iMovie in exactly the same way. I publish new tutorials every weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out. Then hit the little bell icon to get notifications for each new tutorial.